The public loved seeing that equal in a steak. They never for a minute thought I would clear all the meat and cuts away and introduce them into a new world of food. It's called pink slime. I'm here for a meat lesson today. No, when you've broken down a whole beast, you're left with trimmings. You know, in my industry, we call those trimmings all of the bits that no one wants. The bits of sinew, the bits of meat. You're a vegetarian, aren't you, love? E. coli and different stuff like that. Tell these people where the trim goes.
It goes to a rendering plant where they make chicken food, dog food.
Okay, this is not fit for human consumption. Why is it good for dog food? More efficient stomachs, they can handle this stuff. But what would you think if I told you, in America, they've come up with a piece of technology that can turn this into something that ends up in your school food? Pink slime is allowed in any school. The butcher, Dan, you paid to get this taken away, yeah?
Yes.
In this form, this is inedible. Why? Because it's the outside of the meat from the cavity where the guts are. By the USDA. So, this is how I imagine the process to be. Over here, I have something that you probably know well. They don't really put it in a washing machine. All the stuff that Dan pays to get taken away, they put it into a centrifuge and they spin it. It splits the fat from the meat and separates it. So then you end up with stuff like this. I want you to have a look at this. It's important that you kind of see this stuff. Then you end up with all the very, very last bits of meat. What they do is fascinating. And me as a chef and a food lover is shocking. You've probably got one of these cupboards, probably under the sink, with a char block. And in there is going to be all your household chemicals, stuff that you don't want your kids getting their hands on. The key ingredient to the process is ammonia. We're going to wash these lean bits of beef that we've spun around there. I don't know how much. There's a specific ratio. They wash this meat and that kills the E. coli and salmonella and any kind of pathogens. So then we drain it. We drain it and then we mince it. So basically, we're taking a product that would be sold at the cheapest form for dogs. After this process, we can give it to humans. Mince this for me, my friend. Chilies, chopped steaks, tacos. I haven't got anything against a burger. I eat them and I love them. What I have a problem is what is inside it. Where did it come from?